Yeah, Ronak, hold all my calls. People calling in for commentary in this T20 format. Of course, I don't have time for it, so I can't do it. Yeah, hold the call. Say no. We'll see how the next week pans out.
No, Mr. Sidhu, no.
Yes, yes. Especially him, because then he wants parking also in the office. We can't do that. And let's welcome Deep and Aakash, our two international khiladis, back into the fold.
And we've done the place up for them.
We have, and do you like it, by the way, now
very
that
nice,
you mentioned?
Very yeah. Nice.
May I, Cyrus?
All right. Yeah. Yes, please.
The first topic, it's IPL time. We have to talk IPL.
Yes, let's have an IPL happy cheer first.
Woo-hoo!
Yay! Okay, done. Chal, move.
Pa, 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 pa.
We're not trying, bro. Huh.
Sorry. When we think of Delhi Daredevils, what comes to mind? So, what we're going to ask now is the perennial, not I wouldn't call them underachievers, but they've got this horrible history in the IPL.
Horrible history indeed. Unlike other daredevils, the ones from Delhi have been rather unexciting to watch. So much so that they've got our experts to say this.
Brad, why didn't you play for Delhi?
What can I play for Delhi? I'm not playing for Delhi.
Why?
I don't want to play for the bottom team.
Yep, they've struggled through the IPL, finishing at the bottom of the table thrice. But this year, they have a feisty new coach and a go-getter for a captain. And though they lost the first game, we can't help but wonder if Gotti and Punter can turn things around for the Delhi Daredevils.
Aakash, yes. Delhi boy.
Yes, and the reason for that is not just the combination of Ponting and Gambhir, but also have a look at their squad. They've got only one problem, that's the problem of plenty. And that is always a good place to be in.
Right. I think, Ronak, I'll disagree. I think they've underachieved for various reasons. For me, T20 is a very captain-oriented format, and that's where I think Gambhir comes into the picture. I think he's been a fabulous captain. He's aggressive and all that blah, blah, blah on the field. But off the field, I think he handles the dressing room very well, which he's done with KKR.
The thing that the coach does is actually sit at an auction table and pick players. In this case, Ponting did that job. And if you look down the top six of Delhi now, some of the best power hitters are available for them to use in Colin Munro, Jason Roy, Rishabh Pant, Shreyas Iyer, Maxwell. Whether there are some concerns about the bowling.
I think Ponting and Co did a brilliant job with their picks at the auction. They had a strategy in mind, and one big commonality between Gambhir and Ponting is how they back their young players.
What coach really does and is important now that the team is there, is how he manages people who are not playing. There are a lot of international guys who won't be playing, so the dressing room environment,
how to
manage
them. Like, where do they go for shopping and stuff like that?
Well done, sir.
Here are the top pastimes of the DD bench. Think of drinks. Think of shopping in Khan Market. Think of fixing this.
I think they've got the right combination this year with Ponting, because I've heard good things from Mumbai Indians guys when he was there as a captain.
The coach's role actually in T20 cricket, especially franchise cricket, becomes far more important than other cricket. Look at this. Look at the teams that have done well in the IPL. Mumbai under Ponting and Mahela. Tom Moody at Sunrisers is a huge influence. You've had Stephen Fleming at CSK as a massive influence.
On the other hand, they also don't have any anchors. So Gautam Gambhir is the only one. The other batsmen of Delhi play in bursts. So there's Rishabh Pant, there's Maxwell, who may not be able to pace the innings. There's no anchor.
There are two anchors. One is Gautam Gambhir, who plays the role of an anchor. Someone like Shreyas Iyer is expected to play that role as well in the middle order.
Harsha Bogle is also an anchor, but yeah, it's a different
thing. And so is Ronak. But then...
Who's better, Ronak or Harsha Bogle? We change the topic. So you have the tampering.
So you do have two stable pillars who'd hold the innings together.
Gambhir is still explosive. See what he's done to Shahid Afridi.
Yeah. That's good. We'll end on that.